At last! The bell has tolled on the age of the console. The return of the Sovereign.
Welcome, Arisen. We pawns have long awaited your arrival.
Learn all you can of this world you must protect.
We ask that all be spared the horrors of the fell dragon.
From this moment forth, thou art arisen.
Here's my chance.
If you're discovered, yours won't be the only head that rolls. What is your purpose here?
When 'twas all but certain that her son would take his father's place, word reached the castle that the Arisen had been found.
Pitiable Arisen. Why dost thou fight?
Arisen.
Believe in your own destiny, Arisen.
Show me the path thou wouldst walk.
If ye intend to do what I could not, and fell the dragon true, I would gladly pass aught the wisdom I possess into your hands.
How was that? We're excited to finally be able to reveal the release date for Dragon's Dogma 2. First, let's go over what you just saw. Emerging suddenly from the sea, we meet the giant Talos, who appears for the first time in this game, and who you will have to figure out how to stop. We've prepared some additional gameplay footage of Talos, so take a look.
I cannot but fear it will bring ruin wherever it treads.
We shall halt it together.
It seems to me there are plenty of places our feet might find purchase on its hulking frame.
Let us do whatever we can to slow it down. It might prove futile, but it is better than watching on in despair. A puppet with a penchant for destruction is a nuisance nobody asked for. Let us be rid of it.
Indeed. And where is it bound, I wonder?
Left unhindered, it will trample the world entire, but not on our watch. Let us attack with the full sum of our strength. We must try to delay its course by any means!
As you can see, you'll be able to enjoy a variety of combat experiences depending on how you choose to tackle each situation. Keep your eyes peeled for more on Talos and its role. Dragon's Dogma is a tale of the Arisen, whose heart is taken by the dragon. While this sequel mirrors the world setting of the first game, the adventure takes place in a parallel world.
Vermund is the human kingdom, where you will be drawn into the power struggle for the throne. To have her son take the throne, the Queen Regent Disa plots to set a false Arisen. But why are pawns serving a false Arisen? On the other hand, the Beastron nation of Batal treats pawns as the source of misfortune, and instead worship the lambent flame to ward off calamity with Empress Nadinia at its center. Both kingdoms recognize the dragon as a threat, but their thoughts towards pawns and the Arisen differ. What will happen to the player caught between the beliefs and plots of these two nations? You can learn more about some of the game's intriguing characters on our official website. So, check it out. In addition to the main quest line, you can talk to the inhabitants of this world to receive various quests and deepen your relationship with them. For instance, let's look at this quest where you need to befriend some elven siblings.
But Alakalva shall know their issues and know our vessel.
Ah, forgive me. You do not speak our tongue, do you? From this moment forth, so long as you remain by my side, I shall interpret for you.
Nenwen mor I won on. Alkarwa fir nun eldaya menelume sur karil. Martir fa nun fionor, minas vena eralote.
My friend, if e'er I've had need to call upon your aid, tis now. I beg of you to join me in my sister's rescue.
Master, watch out!
This battle is ours!
Tis e'en more nightmarish a sight than I had feared. My father battles the ogre while my sister is clutched in its fist. But there is still hope, if I act quickly. Listen well, friend. I shall strike the beast's arm while my father holds its attention.
This is as much as I can show you for today. Hopefully, you'll find the rest of the quest on your own. In the footage, you can see the Sacred Arbor, which is an elf settlement. The elves there communicate in their own language. And while the Arisen doesn't understand the language of the elves, if there's a pawn nearby who does, they will automatically translate it for you. These specializations that pawns can acquire will make each of them more unique, and hopefully more enjoyable to journey with.
I'll see to it your burdens are shared between us pawns.
It's not only the pawn's personality that reflects the player. Just like in the first game, the player can freely create the Arisen and the main pawn. However, we've used photogrammetry technology to increase photorealism, while adding a way to simplify the process of creating characters. Selecting images that resemble the kind of look you have in mind provides a more intuitive way to create your ideal character. Now, I want to introduce the Trickster, a new vocation that's sure to bring something unique to your gameplay experience. Exclusive to the Arisen, the Trickster is a vocation that wields the sensor and uses the smoke it produces to conjure illusions. By confusing the enemy into fighting themselves through illusions, or increasing the power of pawns beyond the normal parameters for a limited period of time, this vocation focuses on support and use of unique strategies. The Trickster is a devious vocation that takes advantage of the enemy's enhanced behavior AI. It's a great fit for players who prefer to step back from the action and manipulate the battle from the sidelines. Next, we have a few additional details to share. Pre-orders for Dragon's Dogma 2 on PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X, Xbox Series S, and Steam start today. In addition to the standard edition, a deluxe edition will also be available. The deluxe edition includes additional items such as a special camping kit, along with other items that will help you prepare for your journey. Pre-orders of the standard edition will include bonus weapons for each of the four vocations available from the start of the game. And pre-ordering the deluxe edition will give you access to all the bonuses of the standard edition, plus access to additional accessories that can be equipped in-game. I hope you'll consider pre-ordering.
Mechanics have returned, like your weapons getting augmented by your mage party member. Mm-hmm. Who's busy?
Who's like doing something over there?
Are you charging?
Yoo-hoo, Max.
And we got the cat people now. I can't remember the name of the race.
Beastrin.
Yeah. Were they in the online version?
I actually don't know. Yeah, I'm not sure. But they are new to this game.
Yeah. Yeah. One thing I never got to play, unfortunately. But yeah, the locations all feel very familiar, which I appreciate. It really feels like I'm just playing a Dragon's Dogma game that I've been waiting for years and years.
Yeah, it's a totally new map, new locations, but it's still got like a similar feel as the first game, right? Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, and it seems bigger too.
Oh yeah, definitely bigger. I think we've said it's four times the size of the first game. So.
The draw distance is so impressive. Like, everything in the back is super clear. It really makes you want to explore.
Yeah, I'm going to kick them.
You are a self-proclaimed Vista King. What say about the Vista?
I earned that name. We're going to be checking out some Vistas today for sure.
Yeah,
it's like, beautiful.
Look at that.
How did you earn that name?
Exactly. I would like to know as well. You need to fight to keep your title. But yeah, I agree. I think the game looks fantastic.
Yeah, the landscapes, mm-hmm. The mountains look so real.
Yeah, as you mentioned, everything's running on the RE engine, which has been used for all the Resident Evil games since Resident Evil 7.
Monster Hunter Rise.
Yep, Monster Hunter Rise.
Nice. I've been so impressed with it. It's blown me away every time.
Yeah, and I think everybody kind of saw in the showcase the changes to the character creator and how the characters really look super photorealistic, right? Mm-hmm. So you can really make some really cool looking.
I'm just going to stand over here for a second.
I do think this is like the coolest looking dragon.
Absolutely.
That like we've ever seen.
Grigori, you know? One of my favorite dragons in fantasy. He's my Dogma. We're buds.
Oh, are you buds? He like swipes you?
It's okay, I'll put my shield up. Okay. He's a little touchy. Oh,
he's gonna step on you.
Okay, you only have 6 health bars.
Dragon fire looks
fire looks real
amazing.
Hot. Real hot.
Yeah, I only have to get through 6 health bars. That's not too bad.
No problem.
Oh, hold on, I'll impale.
I'm gonna have a pedicure here.
I remember in the first game, you would do like this move, or not that move, but, and then he just swats you away and you're basically dead.
Oh!
And a lot of my friends and I have been wondering like how Grigori's back, because if you played the first game, there's a lot of lore surrounding kind of like the repetitiveness of the universe. And we're curious how Grigori falls into that, because we know there have been different dragons that aren't Grigori, because you find out a lot about that in Dark Arisen.
We haven't confirmed that this is Grigori, but you know,
we'll leave it up to interpretation.
Question marks.
Yeah, I'm
sorry. All right, I'm going in.
This is gonna work out great.
What is the Grigori timeline?
Yeah. I need the Grigori lore.
Lore, yeah, the lore. Oh no.
Yeah, you got this.
The shield though, help check. No problem.
I don't got this. Just a light scratch.
Crispy.
I like you're actually crispy.
Extra crispy.
Look at your face. Oh no.
Still good.
Any other fantasy game, the shield would have blocked all of that.
You would have been totally fine. Not a scratch.
Just staring us down.
Yep. The intimidation. Oh. That'll ruin your day.
It's a little snack.
Still beating, though. Yeah. We're still good.
Classic scene. We've all been here.
Wonder what it tastes like.
Yeah, I'm curious.
I want to know.
Cherry gummy candy.
Oh, yeah.
Out.
I like the weight of this.
Flying
away.
It's huge.
Huge, yeah.
RE Engine's always got really good hair.
The hair is.
She even has like little strands like in her face and stuff, like in real life, you know? Mm-hmm.
The lighting too is just fantastic.
Till then. Just wordlessly leave?
No voice acting for the Arisen in this one, I guess. Oh, they look disappointed. They're like, why didn't she talk to me?
Said it all with a look.
Nonverbal communication is very important in this game.
The ruler of vermin. They still let you send gifts. I'm keeping my waist up.
Yeah, don't give it.
I'm gonna need that.
You can give an apple.
An apple? Yeah, okay. Here's one ripened apple.
Yum.
Oh, none. You can either say you liked it or you loved it. I loved it.
No negativity.
No negativity.
That's nice.
Yeah, no downvoting. All right, I'm out of here. This is where you've been. Oh. Hello, Dahlia. Goodbye, Dahlia.
Oh, just running off?
Back here.
Hey, you.
Oh, I think I'm supposed to follow. Hail. Oh, so it seems like we took like the back end or something. The Arisen's attentions are
always in demand. Oh, you have to do the campfire.
Oh yeah, how do I do that?
I want you to look at the meat. I'm really excited for you about this.
Do I not have one?
You might not have it.
Oh, you're gonna have to do that.
I'm gonna have. Okay, one of us will do it. Don't worry. We've really hyped it. We've hyped it like big time.
It's gonna deliver, though. Don't worry.
I need to see it.
Yeah, stay tuned for the for that.
We'll deliver. It's gonna be the height of it.
It's gonna be the height.
I'm ready now. Take me.
Let us. The capital. Ooh. Yes.
Escort mission. Gonna travel us or take us to the capital. Our little guide.
Now you're rolling deep. You have a lot of people now.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Wait, who's it? Oh yeah, we
have. Oh, you have. Wow.
That's what I'm saying.
Team. Here.
Party of eight.
Oh, here we go. Okay, we're gonna go in for a. Let's do a sweep shot. Get swept.
Oh, the shields though.
Yeah. Oh, put them on the ground. Let's go.
There we go. Now Gimli's down.
Roasted.
Nice.
Oh, literally roasted.
Oh, off the edge?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, not you.
Oh.
It's okay, sorry.
Sarah, no.
Oh, he's dead.
Oh, he's gone.
I'm gonna throw one of them, I swear. Where are you? Right, what fails to destroy us only enhances our
chances. It's like a fortune cookie.
What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Yeah. Thanks, Dad.
I learned so much.
I gotta follow my guide. Those helpful magic to cast
have worn off. Oh, there's a bunch of them.
Out of the way!
Hello? Oh, there we go.
Oh.
Yeah, light me on fire first, please. Thank you.
Oh!
One shot. I like, it seems to, if you don't want to aim like this for like fine tuning, you seem to be able to just like auto shoot.
Oh, you just break up your vocation as well.
Oh, perfect.
That's awesome.
Need some new abilities. Oh, is that the capital? Okay.
I think you're still kind of far from it, but I'm not sure.
Maybe it's a fort. Can we look at the waterfall?
I was going to say, I want to look at the water.
And there was like a cloud formation higher up.
That's so pretty.
Very
Maybe
in a minute.
Okay, I'm just going to
close range.
Stomp. There we go.
Ooh.
All
right.
Oh, still? Oh, the rock.
Oh!
another way to do it.
Oh, Sarah with like the brutal.
Trying to enjoy
nature?
Yeah, that nature.
Having a meditative moment here and you had to throw a rock at a harpy? Whatever.
What a move. Look at that grass.
Yeah, look at all that.
And you get the feeling of like wind through the, you know, breeze through the grass.
Like a lot of games, like, well, we got trees. Well, what kind of trees? I don't know. They're trees. Like these trees, these look like.
Waypoint are you going for?
Which one should I go for?
You should try the woods.
It's open world.
It's your choice.
Your choice, yeah.
I'm going to go down this main path and then go to the right, I think. Yes?
Yes.
Do it.
The amount of paths and openness is insane, too. Crazy to see.
It is. It's like... super like I get very distracted with these kinds of games, though. I just want to explore. Oh, no, they're back.
Get them.
Want to see everything.
Don't put me to sleep.
This was one of
Oh, that's a boulder.
Carrying the boulder.
Hey, oh no, it fell out of.
Get away from me.
So if you hit up on the D-pad, that commands the pawns to go, and they'll basically try to shoot them out of the air for you.
Oh, that's good. I need the pawns.
There you go.
Oh,
there we go.
Nice. That was your chance.
Well, it's dead.
Oh, it's dead.
You can pick it up.
Take each trial as it comes. Too easy.
It is nice to have capable companions.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's like, why are you even here?
Yeah.
It's one of the games where, like, if the person is built the pawn properly, they are almost always a boon to have with you and not so much a detriment. I really appreciated it for that. Yeah. Oh, big town.
Oh, no. Not again.
Oh,
levitating.
You're going to get it.
I'm going to get put to sleep again?
Run away.
That's another thing I love about these games is the magic casting looks like magic casting.
Yeah.
It's so intricate looking. They like the floating in the air and summoning lightning down.
Yeah.
You don't get that in a lot of games.
You charge up a really powerful spell and then, you know, afterwards they're all tired. That's
it's very feels satisfying. Real, you know?
Did we get it? Yeah. Did we get it? We're gonna move on.
A boulder. We're just seeing them now.
Just throw the boulder.
Is Sarah still here?
Oh.
Sarah is not here anymore. Now we got some different people. All right, George.
I like George.
Do something.
That's your chance. ground-based.
Oh, yes!
I do like that.
What'd you call it earlier? The screen.
Oh, the fighting wind. So biting. Okay. See? I can do something.
As long as you're not
flying.
This was my favorite class to play in the original.
I just like how fast it is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's like super, super fun.
I confess myself mystified.
It was like one of the stronger ones for like grappling onto the monsters to use for the bowl. Oh, whoa. Eviscerated.
I'm crazy.
Just really like fell over.
Got shredded.
Oh no. Oh,
more of those.
Not these guys again.
With how like melee focused the thief has become, I can definitely see like people wanting to make sure that their party has like the ranged options.
Yeah.
Especially now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's like one of the key elements, right? I mean, there are some hybrid vocations, but it's you gotta have that right party composition.
This game's always been about like proper party composition.
You need to make like the tent.
Oh.
Like, what?
Oh yeah, you have a camping kit.
What is that?
The camping. Down?
Yeah, there we go.
Oh yeah, at a.
But
at
we
a
need to go site. To a campsite yeah. though first.
Oh.
Like a campfire.
The
if we don't run into one, might be your you have to be the one to take that on. As your main quest.
We'll do it.
To show
at all costs, we will show this.
The menu system seemed very reminiscent of the first one too, which
hey,
is cool.
Hey, don't yeah. do that to and him.
Combining was always a huge factor too, so mm-hmm. it's cool that you can still do that. I stockpiled potions all the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, yeah, it's a must.
Are you a hoarder too? A game item hoarder?
Absolutely.
Oh, you guys should.
You got
should,
him.
You guys should yeah. have like a.
You never know
like
when
a
you're
support,
need it.
Like a yeah. support group yeah. or something.
Always fully encumbered.
Right.
which is really, you have to watch that in this game too, right? Because the more stuff you're holding on to, the worse your stamina and stuff like that's going to be.
What is it on the map, this like stone?
I think that's a rift stone.
It might be under the bridge.
Oh.
Can you show the main map for a second, actually? I just like the way it looks.
Yeah.
Like it looks nice like somebody like hand drew. Look at the water.
It kind of looks like one of those medieval prints.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very cool.
Fits the vibe.
If I go down here, will I
think you're okay.
Dunk in the water?
What's to do down here?
I want to.
You just want to see it?
I want to look at the.
That water looks dirty.
I want to see.
Don't
want
to go in the water.
No.
Oh, it's like broken.
Oh, yeah, it's broken.
Oh.
See if you can activate it.
Oh, is it?
Oh.
Oh.
Secrets.
Oh. Can fix it.
Oh.
Oh, I can't fix it. Oh, yes, I can.
Oh, I should. Something's happening.
Aha! There it is.
Hooray!
How's it going to swap out your pawns?
That guy just came out.
Oh.
Oh, I guess not.
Huh? I guess I can fix it.
It looks like you just summoned a guy and then he just walked away.
He just walked away, though.
He's like, all right, thanks.
I'm free.
I'm back.
Okay. Interesting. I just wanted to see it. This is what I love about these kinds of games, because you do have, like, what's that over there kind of
fiddling around.
Motivation, yeah, yeah. You know?
And in this
Oops.
Series especially, that could be incredibly dangerous.
Yeah.
The cabin.
Oh, you want to go in the cabin? It looks scary.
It's very Resident Evil right here.
Yeah.
I know.
Resident Evil 4 opening right here.
You're about to run.
No.
The other way, turn left.
Oh my god.
Whoa. That one's making a stand.
Oh, they're attacking the ox.
There's a bunch of them.
Animal cruelty, no.
Save it. No, I think it's
too late.
Oh, he's gone. He's
no animals were harmed in the
middle. No.
Can you eat it though?
Now you're going to get
it. Become delicious
now
dinner.
You're going to get this.
Oh.
Now you're going to get this. It's going to become delicious dinner. Canada?
Got a shield.
Oh, I just went through the ox. Okay.
I like that the pawns can still like jump on them and like make them vulnerable for you.
Yeah.
Exam.
Oh no.
Oh, you'll bee steak.
Bee steak.
That we
yes.
need that for
we
the
do
cooking
need that.
Later,
we do
but
need
also
it's not rotten.
Why
did that
fell out of the sky?
I was going this way, right?
Yeah.
Northeast.
You have to be my GPS
yeah.
people.
Yeah. More harpies.
Oh, get him. Kill the harpy. Where
to next? I'll just buy them.
And one of the things about this game is that it doesn't necessarily
time like we were all going across this very narrow bridge, and one of my pawn just fell off. It was like, well, that's the end of that
Oh,
one.
Oh, there's somebody over there. Are they fighting?
It's realistic physics, yeah. Right? The drawbridge.
Are those bandits?
Wait, what's happening? Yeah.
Oh,
are they?
Oh. Well. Yeah, you guys
fight
are
fight for your life.
Oh, throw them in. Throw I guess throw we're gonna. Throw them in.
Oh, no.
Oh, they're
going to
talk.
Talia. Talia heard you.
Yeah.
Just yeeted.
You guys should add voice commands.
All right. I shall know my pain twofold. Something now.
But I got that dude was just standing on the bridge and he was like,
over there. Just
go.
Also, I can't help myself but to gather everything.
Oh, you got it. And then give it to your
phone. See, we all have our gaming hang-ups.
I truly have no self-control. I don't know what that herb does, and I don't care.
You can hoard it, though.
I just want it.
You can hoard it.
I need to have it. I'm going to get this one, too. See? I'm going to get it.
Nice.
They're heavy now.
Oh. Do I need to get rid of something?
It'll affect your stamina, but
it might not still walk.
Yeah, you can still walk.
But should I get rid of something?
I know the camping kit is like 7 kilograms.
I dropped like 2 sprigs of basil because that's what I think that's what's weighing me down, you know?
Those ounces were killing you.
You're like a new person.
Oh, my stamina.
Oh,
my stamina. And the things? Where the wolves.
Morgues or something.
They hunt in packs.
Get them.
They do indeed.
Took a dive there.
No, it's okay. We're fine.
Oh, they jump off you.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh. There it goes. There it goes. Watch it.
Onto the
other ledge.
Slowly but surely. Oh, I ranked up again. Nice.
You're going to be max level by the end of this?
Yes. I'll be here all day.
Cook something.
Let's see. Do I have.
You
what
should
it takes?
Have. Yeah, you have the camping and you have.
Do I have meats? Yeah. A dried meat?
Dried meat is fine.
All right. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right.
Got meats. You got
nuts. I think there's a campfire like by the river somewhere.
Oh, it's over there, I think. Maybe? Well, let's just go over there. Oh,
big
the big
town,
city.
Big town.
Maybe we can go over there.
That's cool.
I think that's a more interesting. Oh, this is. Oh, we have a big showdown here, maybe. I see something big.
Is that what I think?
Is it the griffin again?
Who's to say? I'm gonna hide in this wheat field.
Uh oh.
Oh, there it is.
Oh no.
I'm gonna.
All right, you gotta fight.
You gotta fight it.
Oh, he only
just
has
try.
4 health.
Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
It's fine.
Oh.
It's happening.
I'm gonna jump and grab.
Oh,
that's actually perfect.
Oh,
get on
his tail.
I've got the tail.
Grab a tail.
There we go.
Yes.
There we go. Now we're talking. Slash.
One of the best mechanics
on.
In this
Hold
game.
Hold on.
My stamina is rapidly draining.
Yeah, I don't know about this.
Charge these up.
Hold on.
Charge it up. I need to.
Here we go.
Yes.
Impale.
I need to get up to a better spot. But I also need to let go soon.
You did like a pip of damage, by the way.
If you open your inventory, I think you could drink a potion that would give you more stamina.
Oh, yes, get off here. I'm fine. Yes, I'm good.
Get off here. This is
you've
my
done
stuff.
So much damage.
I have done some damage.
A pip of damage has happened.
Oh, it's back.
Oh no, it's gonna scratch you. Thanks.
I'm really happy we can choose which way is the.
Oh, that's okay.
I got some
that
shots
okay.
in
here.
I'm doing
okay,
all right.
Okay, now you can get back on. Now that your stamina has recharged.
Oh, it ran away.
Oh, is it? Oh my gosh.
Go for the head.
Oh.
Stop focusing on the
I'm trying to grab on.
You're just on the tail.
You're really on the wrong side of this here. Little fur butt.
Oh, it's got like a beak and teeth. That's scary.
Oh, is it getting tired?
Come on.
Oh.
Oh.
That was better and he landed on the beak.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, he's like.
See?
Oh.
He's like, no. One. Get it. Oh.
A lot of people would sometimes make like
nice.
A comparison to this game, like with Moss Hunter, just because.
Nice, you did it.
The ability to like cut off limbs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Very reminiscent. And it's very satisfying. And just some as of satisfying.
The, later on, Monster Hunter, you can climb too.
Yeah.
Monsters.
Yeah, exactly. Which
feels like this. You're going the wrong way.
I need to take this bridge.
No. Go back down.
And then
go to the
to
right.
The right?
Yeah.
You're sure?
I think so.
You sound confident.
I'm very confident.
Oh, there it is. Oh, there it is.
What?
I should have
doubted.
Wait, I gotta do this first.
It'd be really sad if
I died here.
Died here.
I'll let these pawns do some work.
It's okay, we got the safety wake
stone. Go into the healing
yeah,
bubble.
True, that's true.
Oh, it feels so good in
there. Oh, it's so
good. Yeah.
Is that healing?
Yeah, you're in like a healing
ooh.
Aura.
Ooh, nice.
There we go.
Is that a
very good. Very well done.
All right.
Look at that.
All right.
Camp time.
Here we go.
We can wrap it up with this.
I mean, this is the best place to stop.
Make a camp.
A very modest, comfortable camp.
This food's not going to be modest, let me tell you.
Oh, you get to vibe with your pawns. That's so nice.
Oh. Cooked. Here we go.
Why'd they do that?
Dried meat.
Watch. It's so cool.
Oh, we get to cut some.
Oh. Whoa! Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Aren't you hungry now?
Look at that.
That
looks
look
at real.
It's Wagyu. Capcom meat cooking is always top notch. We know.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. You know we love our food.
That's right. I appreciate that.
How deep is this?
Some free fish.
Oh, I would not.
I can't make that. Oh,
no.
Oh, George.
George, get out of that water,
George.
Let's
just see what happens.
Let's see what happens.
Whoa.
Cyclops.
Oh.
Get it.
It's coming at me.
Oh, he's,
oh
yeah,
it's
he's
swinging like crazy.
Mad. Oh, George.
Oh.
George, though. This is where you can really see like the physics.
Oh, yeah. Because
it's like lumbering around.
It's like knocking over trees and stuff.
Yeah.
Going for the eye.
Oh, yes. Nice.
Oh, you got him.
Just scratch out its eyes.
There you
super
go.
Super effective.
Whoa!
Oh, is he gonna fall?
He's gonna try to. It's trying to rip you out of his face.
Losing his balance.
Stamina.
Dang.
Can I get it before my stamina?
You might,
you're
well,
so
it's
close.
Two things.
Oh,
so you gotta do.
Oh
one.
Yeah. Oh my god.
That'll ruin your day.
Oh. Take a breather. Oh, I'm gonna get clubbed.
Oh!
Okay.
I miscalculated.
Pawn death. Well,
it wasn't
my death,
so
it's fine.
Yeah, that's surprisingly, you took like no damage there.
Oh, the pawn is blinking. Sarah is blinking furiously at you. You refuse to revive her.
Got priority.
Sarah, though. Oh, Sarah.
Do it.
It's fine.
Sarah's the one with the boulder, right?
Yeah, Sarah was
there we
like,
go,
clutch.
There
we need Sarah.
One thing at a time, we can get there.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh.
The lizard folk.
Oh, that was, okay, yeah, much more.
Oh!
Now you should eat some meat that you just cooked.
Oh, he's...
Eat it. No way.
You require assistance?
yeah, can you maybe
you.
Do a thing? Thanks.
Oh, and then it regens you.
Oh, come on, I thought I had that one.
There you go. Now you got it.
Oh! Oh, man. Got clubbed.
Oh, that's rough.
Yes. Oh. Get back on. Climb up. Oh, no! I got sat on.
Yes, use the wake stone.
Yeah,
oh, my gosh.
Safety wake stone.
Always have your wake stone.
Listen, kids.
Yeah. Don't go outside
PSA.
Without
them. Go.
Bring your jacket, bring your wake stone. Yes, this is it. This is it.
I think people would be really surprised with like how resilient certain monsters are. But then once you figure out their weaknesses,
the
you can like turn certain situations that were
this
hard before.
Oh, he's gonna fall. He's gonna fall.
I got a...
He fell against the tree.
Against the tree, wow.
It's like propped up by the tree while you stab.
What is happening here?
Wow.
Oh! Where am I?
You're still on fire.
Get off.
I think it's your mages.
Yeah.
I did not think it would take into account like the being propped up.
Oh, good block.
Being very tactical now. In the water?
Well, it's a lizard. It could probably swim. Okay, very close here. Very close.
Wiggling away? What is that sparkler thing? I'm
that's
worried about that.
Powder
that's
bomb?
The, yeah, from one of your pawns, I think.
Yeah. Whoa!
That's it.
You're almost there.
Last one.
One more.
Two more.
Oh!
Oh, that one's just a little.
Oh, no! Off the edge I go.
That's so cool.
Oh, this guy. Well, this guy's going to get it now.
Where did you come from?
Yeah. You are not supposed to be here. Yeah. Yeah.
Dunzo. All right.
And then that last little bit.
Finishing strike.
Oh, and you leveled up your vocation.
You've done everything.
Yeah.
You did it all.
I did it.
The action gameplay is designed to challenge your creativity, and although this is a single-player adventure, AI-controlled companions will accompany you throughout the experience. Today, I'd like to show you a little of what you can expect from the world of Dragon's Dogma 2 with this new gameplay footage. In Dragon's Dogma 2, up to three AI-controlled beings called Pawns can join you on your adventures. Players can choose from four starting vocations that determine how they will play. Of course, you will be able to change your vocation at any time by visiting vocation guilds. For now, let's look at the fighter vocation. Wielding a one-handed sword and shield, the fighter excels in melee combat. As a fighter, you can cut down enemies with a sword and protect yourself and your party using your shield. As we keep going, we can see some harpies in the distance. As an archer, you'll be better suited to take down enemies above you. Let's see what they can do. The archer is a vocation that uses a bow and arrow to attack enemies from a distance. Make full use of your arsenal, including exploding or blighting arrows. You can also aim at your enemies like a third-person shooter. The monsters of Dragon's Dogma 2 behave organically in the world around them, and will even react to players by using their wits against you. Next, I would like to show you the mage in action. Mages excel at long-range magical attacks, as well as healing and support spells that bolster your party with various enchantments to give allies an advantage in battle. The more advanced and powerful the magic is, the longer the incantation will take. In addition to the pawns you adventure with, you will occasionally act with other inhabitants of the world.
What's this? We're trapped!
Lastly, let's take a look at the thief. As a thief, you use daggers to strike at your enemies, relying on agility and quick attacks. Use Swift Step to quickly move away from enemies after an attack. The key strategy for the thief against massive monsters is to find openings and cling on to the enemy to deal damage. Fighting head-on is always an option, but it's a good idea to utilize the environment around you while engaging with enemies. Between your chosen vocation, diverse terrains, and the particular monster you're up against, each encounter challenges players and their party to use their creativity to succeed. Two nations prosper in the world of Dragon's Dogma 2. Vermund, the human kingdom, and Batal, the land of Beastrin. In Vermund, the Arisen who slay the dragon have ruled as kings for generations. This land of lush meadows and rolling hills is ripe for exploration. In contrast, Batal is a rugged canyon nation with a city built on the site of ancient ruins. It is home to the Beastrin and their unique culture. The nation of Batal offers players a different experience from the human kingdom, with diverse environments to explore and monsters to encounter. In your adventures, you might come across people who call out to you.
Oh, have you some business with the apothecary, sir?
Other times, you might receive quests from people who you aid.
Thank heavens. Thought I'd ne'er make it. If
I might be so bold as to impose upon you again. Would you be willing to accompany me to the cenotaph and safeguard me from harm?
Pawns with knowledge of a quest may be able to guide you to the right location, but it is up to the player to decide whether to follow them or not. Pawns support you throughout your adventures and may come to your aid when you are in trouble. To complete your quests, you can ride ox carts to travel to major locations. But be aware, as you might get attacked en route to your destination and have to decide how to tackle the situation. During the ride, you can choose to close your eyes to quickly arrive at your destination. Time is ever passing, even while riding an ox cart, and the environment around the player constantly changes. Nighttime is especially dangerous. With no light to illuminate your surroundings, you will be enveloped in pitch black darkness where you can't even see your feet. Also, there are dangerous monsters that only appear at night, so you need to be careful when adventuring in the dark. If you have a camping kit, you can find a campsite to spend the night and recover your health.
Good evening, Arisen. Tis the honor of my life to share your journey, Arisen.
To wrap up, I'd like to introduce some advanced vocations that become available as you progress in the story. The Mystic Spear Hand combines magic attacks and weapon-based physical attacks. A good all-rounder, they use their duo spear at close range and magic at long range. They can also use magic to block an enemy's movement or throw multiple items at once. The Magic Archer is a vocation that further specializes in long-range attacks with magical arrows.
The dragon will appear before you when the tide has come.
Look out, Arisen! We're under attack!
Not here, you beast! Come and face me! Monster, watch out! Formidable, Arisen.
Those who can be of aid to you will reveal themselves in time.
Thy will, thy soul, these are all the means thou hast to carve thy path anew. Yet your wicked schemes will avail you not, watching one.
From the dragon's flames.
You need only believe in your own destiny, Arisen.
Of course, that begs the question. If he's a mere mummer, then where might our true Arisen? Empress Nadinia's life is in your hands, Sir Arisen.
Praise be, for only the Sovereign's guidance can lead us true. Long live the Sovereign of Vermont!
Drinking a It's all about humanity.